Now, children, we are going to represent this particular equation. It is a linear equation in two variables, x and y. And we are going to represent this on a graph, and we'll see how its graph will look like. Then you'll understand more why it is called a linear equation. Here, this is having two variables, and the degree of the equation is one. So now, how we are going to solve this? The best way is whenever you have an equation, first you put the value of x is equal to 0. When you put x is equal to 0, you'll have 0 plus 2y is equal to 6. This 2 comes over here, you will have y is equal to 3, write y here. Similarly, when you have, now you put y is equal to 0. In most of the questions, it is easy to do like that. I put y is equal to 0. Instead of y, I put 0. So x plus 2 into 0 is equal to 6. So this becomes 0. So x is equal to 6. You get the value of x is equal to 6. Now we will put y is equal to 1. See, whenever you're having an equation, it is always easy that you put the value of the variable which is having a coefficient. Because for divide करते हुए coefficient का problem नहीं होगा. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पे 2y है, तो हम y का वैल्यू यहाँ पुट करेंगे. इट्स अप टू यू, आप कहीं भी डाल सकते हैं, लेकिन आसान ये होगा कि अगर आपने यहाँ पे वैल्यू पुट किया रादर देन यहाँ, क्योंकि इसके साथ एक कोएफिशिएंट है. अब अगर दोनों में अगर कोएफिशिएंट है, तो आप उसमें वैल्यू पुट करना जिसके कोएफिशिएंट से डिविजन मुश्किल है, उसमें आप वैल्यू पुट करना. अब इस केस में यहाँ पे आपका कोएफिशिएंट है, तो आपने यहाँ पे टू वाई के जगह हमने 1 पुट किया, तो ये 2 आया यहाँ पे, एक्स प्लस 2 उधर गया, तो ये 4 आया. वैसे अगले में मैंने y इज इक्वल टू 2 पुट किया, तो 2 इंटू 2 4 हो गया, तो x का वैल्यू 2 आया. तो इस तरीके से हमें इनके वैल्यूज, इस इक्वेशन में x एंड y के वैल्यूज को हमने निकाला. अब उसके बाद हम लोग उसको प्लॉट करेंगे. नाउ दैट वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड द वैल्यूज देयर ऑफ x एंड y, व्हेन x वाज 6 y वाज 0, व्हेन y वाज 0 यू गॉट, व्हेन x वाज 0 यू गॉट y एज 3. जब हमने y को 1 रखा, x 4 आया, y को 2 रखा, तो x भी 2 आया. ठीक है, ये वैल्यूज हमने वहाँ कैलकुलेट किया, उसको हम प्लॉट करेंगे. तो प्लॉटिंग में देखना कैसा होता है. ठीक है, सबसे पहला फर्स्ट पॉइंट जो a है, वो प्लॉट हुआ है यहाँ पे. फिर b प्लॉट हुआ, देखो, फिर d प्लॉट हुआ है आपका, फिर e, उसके बाद इनमें से पास होने वाला ये लाइन. और आप देख रहे हैं इस लाइन का जो इक्वेशन है, क्लियरली यहाँ पे आया x प्लस 2y इज इक्वल टू 6, जो आपका वहां का इक्वेशन था. समझ में आ गया होगा आपको ये. आफ्टर ड्रॉइंग द ग्राफ वी हैव सम कंक्लूशंस दैट वी कैन गेट फ्रॉम दैट. दैट इज एवरी पॉइंट दैट सेटिस्फाई द इक्वेशन x प्लस 2y इक्वल टू 6 लाई ऑन द लाइन. एंड फॉर एवरी पॉइंट ए बी दैट इज ऑन द लाइन, x विल बी ए एंड y विल बी बी. And for every point that does not lie in the on the line is not a solution of the equation. Now let me just explain what was there in the previous slide. All those points that are lying on this line are the solutions of this equation x plus 2y is equal to 6. If any point that will be lying outside, suppose this point m, which is having the coordinate 2 minus 3, is not a solution of this equation. That means if I put the value of x as 2 and y as minus 3, I will not get 6. It won't satisfy the equation. Then, while you are writing the ordered pair, you should always remember 0 stands for x and y stands, 3 stands for y. Here, x is equal to 2, y is equal to 2. Similarly, here, x is equal to 4 and y is equal to 2. And one more, finally, one more thing. In the earlier slide, I had told you why we call this a linear equation in two variables. It is because when I plot this particular equation with the points or the solutions, I get a straight line. A linear equation always gives you a straight line. That is why you call it a linear equation. I hope this much is clear. Now let us plot the points which we had calculated for the equation x plus y equals to 7. So the first point was 7 comma 0. This is 7 comma 0. The second point 0 comma 7. B shows 0 comma 7. Then you have 2 comma 5. X is 2 and y is 5. You can see. Then D is 4 comma 3. This is 4. X is 4 and y is 3. Then you have one negative value also, x is minus 1 and y is 8. Now let us see whether we can draw a line passing through all these 3 points, all these 5 points in fact. So you can see this is the line of the equation or graph of the equation x plus y equals to 7. I think you might have followed this. In this way, in this particular GeoGebra, so using that I can show you so many graphs. Suppose I have got a graph like 3x plus 5 is equal to 10. How will it look like? You have this is 3x plus 5 equals to 10. If you take any point on this line and if you take the coordinate, suppose x is 0 and y is 2, if you put x 0 and y 2, this equation will be satisfied. So every point lying on this line will satisfy this equation. I can show you another graph. That is minus 5 plus y is equals to 9. How will it look like? This is going to be that line of this particular graph, this particular equation. So even if I take any point on this line, any point I take on this line, and if I substitute on the x and y values, it will satisfy this equation. So these are various graphs of some of the equations. Okay, I hope it's clear.